Ever since 1961, Rotel has been building affordable yet high-performance audio gear, specializing in two-channel stereo products. Audio Advice has been a Rotel dealer since 1981 when we first heard one of their integrated amplifiers. Their consistent sound and build quality over the years has been very impressive when you consider they are about to celebrate their 60th anniversary. This video is on two new products from Rotel that have a very interesting twist. We'll be looking at the A11 and CD11 Tribute Series. If you want to read our full review on the new Rotel Tribute Series, be sure to click the link below to be taken to our full article on audioadvice.com. Now let's get started. If you follow the craft food or beverage industry, you've probably noticed something pretty interesting happening over the past few years. We're starting to see collaborations between businesses you might think might be competitors in an effort to produce something even better and more interesting for their customers who frequent those establishments. In our home state of North Carolina, we are seeing it all the time now between local breweries. Interestingly enough, the Tribute Series is the first audio collaboration we can remember in multiple decades. How we arrived with this Tribute gear is a nice but somewhat sad story. Marantz was founded by Saul Marantz in the 1950s, and like Rotel, is highly regarded in the industry for making great sounding gear for the money. Ken Ishiwata worked for Marantz for 40 years. He had a special knack for looking at a simple piece of gear and figuring out how to make it sound a lot better without raising the price much at all. In Ken's last years at Marantz, he became their international brand ambassador, but he was really more of an ambassador for great sound. He believed enjoying music was one of the best aspects life had to give and was passionate about spreading his love of music and great sound. The chief technology officer at Rotel, Daren Orth, and Ken had been friends for many years and both had great mutual respect for each other. In the summer of 2019, they started initial conversations on how they could finally work together. The Rotel team and Ken took a look at the current Rotel lineup and were very interested in modifying the A11 integrated amplifier. It had just been awarded Best Buy Amplifier of 2019 and 20 by the Expert Imaging and Sound Association. The companion CD11 was chosen as the perfect CD player to mate up with the amp. Ken then came up with the initial changes and had prototypes of the new designs produced. In the early fall of 2019, the Rotel team agreed with the new designs and it looked like things were going to move forward. Tragically, Ken passed away in November of 2019 before final production began on these. Rotel contacted his son and daughter to see if they were interested in Rotel continuing with these as a tribute to their father's contributions to the audio industry. They wholeheartedly agreed, and the tribute models were put into production for a fall 2020 release. The A11 and CD11 tribute models come from the very heart of the Rotel value lineup, with both of them being well below $1,000 a unit. The tribute models bear a badge on the front and are available in a black or silver finish. Fit and finish are quite nice for the price, with the buttons and controls having a nice firm feel. These units are quite simple in design and also easy to operate right from the front panel or with the included remote controls. Both have detachable power cords with good quality connections on the rear. With the front panel displays being of the same design, these two guys look great with the amp stacked right on top of the CD player. Their slim size means this stack will only take up just a little more than 7 inches of height. The A11 Tribute integrated amp has enough inputs for just about any type of two-channel audio system. You'll get 4 analog inputs, a moving magnet phono input, Bluetooth AdaptX, and even a set of preamp outputs you could use for a subwoofer or separate power amp later. You can connect 2 pairs of speakers and control them for A and B, or B. The front panel gives you a mini headphone connector and the buttons for the sources. The only caveat is that there are 2 aux inputs and only 1 button which toggles between aux 1 and aux 2. We found a few features in the menu we really love though. First, you'll have full adjustments for bass and treble and balance. You can set the dim level on the front panel as well. Some of you may want to keep your 2-channel system in the same room as your home theater, and while it's not obvious the A11 Tribute has a home theater bypass, it does. Rotel lets you tell the unit if you want aux 2 to be set up this way, which is pretty cool. The next trick is something we wish everyone would do. It seems many products are adding Bluetooth these days, but the issue always with Bluetooth is you have 2 volume controls, your phone and the unit. The A11 Tribute lets you set up the Bluetooth input for fixed or variable volume. So you would set it to be about as loud as you ever played things, then have full control of the volume for your smartphone. There's even a sleep timer and an auto sensing you can gauge to turn the unit on and off, which means if you have auto sensing turned on, as soon as it sees a signal, the unit would turn itself on. Ken Ishiwata took this already award-winning layout and made quite a few changes. In the preamp section, 6 of the capacitors were upgraded. The power amp section had 10 capacitors and 2 resistors in the signal path changed. Finally, custom damping materials were added to reduce mechanical noise in the chassis. As far as CD players go, the CD11 Tribute is pretty similar to what you might expect from a feature standpoint, although we have to say it's heavier than you'd expect for a CD player in this price range. The front panel has all of your transport functions with a center loading disc tray. Rear connections include left and right outs, plus a digital out. The Tribute version of the CD player received a lot of modifications from Ken Ishiwata. The DAC section had 8 capacitor upgrades and 1 resistor change. The power supply was almost completely redone, with all the capacitors being upgraded to better components. Since the CD player does vibrate from the spinning of the disc, Ken put a lot of attention into damping out internal vibrations. He also made changes to the electrical and mechanical grounding of the player. We could not wait to plug these up and give them a spin. Normally, I'll take an amplifier and connect it up to speakers far beyond its price range, but this time, I wanted to see how good the A11 Tribute could make a good value pair of speakers sound. I picked the Paradigm Atom, which is a small bookshelf speaker that sounds fantastic for the money. Obviously, we used the CD11 CD player. If you're lucky enough to become an owner of the A11 Tribute or both, the first time you turn things on, don't worry if you have the volume level where you think would be fine and get no sound. Rotel chose to offer a super wide range of adjustments across the entire spectrum. With the level set at 35, I could barely hear anything. But what this means is, unlike a lot of amplifiers, you can really fine-tune the volume for low-level listening. From the first bar, if you would have been in the room, you would have heard me say, "Wow, that is sweet sounding." This combination has a natural sound that is very pure and sweet, almost old-school tube-like, yet with all the details. The first track I tried was indeed old school with She's Leaving Home from Sgt. Pepper's. The layers and layers I heard on this track was just incredible. Every note and voice hung in a space totally separated, but what really got me was how smooth yet open the presentation was. To give things a real test of imaging and layering, I moved on to an early Chesky CD of Beethoven's Concerto for Violin and Orchestra in D Major, Opus 61. Here, the ability to pick out every instrument in the orchestra was pretty astounding. And like with the first cut, the soundstage was wide with great separation. For a test of dynamics, along with rhythm and pacing, I dropped in Gunslinger from John Fogerty's Revival album. This is a fun album to listen to, and in this cut, the ability to portray the rhythm of the cut really stood out. Dynamics and bass impact were also great too, although the Little Adams did run out of gas in their deep bass ability here. The bottom line for us is, this $1,400 stack of electronics is super sweet, very easy to listen to, and yet capable of portraying the little tiny micro details from both a dynamic and tonal standpoint that really draws you into the music. The price category of these new Rotel Tribute products fall into is certainly very crowded with some stiff competition. However, none of them pay homage to one of the great people in the audio industry like the Tribute pieces do. Ken Ishiwata influenced many people over his 40 plus years in the audio business, and it's likely one of them designed a component you might be listening to now. We think it's great you can put a piece of history into your system that not only is full of great features, but is just a barrel of fun to listen to. If you pair up this stack with a moderate to efficient pair of speakers, you'll love its sweet, natural presentation. If you have any questions about the Rotel Tribute gear, feel free to reach us via call, chat, or email, or drop into one of our stores in the Raleigh or Charlotte, North Carolina area. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a like and subscribe to our channel for all the latest content in high performance audio and home theater. We'll see you next time.